Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create customizable latte coffee art. I provided this photo as a base for us to work on. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you haven't already subscribed to Blue Lightning TV, click that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a high contrast black and white graphic, which will be the source of our latte art. It could be a logo, clip art, or even text. We'll place it onto the coffee cup image. If the Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard. Drag your graphic onto the tab of the base photo, and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Reduce the graphic's opacity so we can see the cup under it. To resize our graphic, open the Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using a later version, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the Transform's bounding box and drag the graphic. To rotate it, go to a corner and drag it clockwise or counterclockwise to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. We can now increase its opacity back to 100%. Since the nature of foamed milk doesn't have sharp corners or edges, I'll show you a quick, effective way to round out our graphic. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it between 3 to 6 pixels. Keep in mind, the more you blur it, the more the shape of the graphic will be rounded out. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Threshold. The default amount is 128. Basically, any pixels lighter than 128 are converted to white, and any pixels darker than 128 are converted to black. Dragging the threshold to the left constricts all the shapes, while dragging it to the right expands them. Choose a threshold that has the balance that looks good for your graphic. Keep in mind, if the corners are too round or conversely too sharp, you can always go back to adjust the amount of blur. Hide the background and open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click any of the channel thumbnails to make a selection of the shape. Open back the Layers panel. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the white area surrounding our graphic. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Make the background visible again. We want to convert our graphic into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right to open the flyout list and click Convert to Smart Object. Double-click an empty area of the layer next to your graphic to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color Box. Pick White and click OK. The blend mode is normal and the opacity is 100%. Click Satin and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, type in F6EDC5. The blend mode is Multiply, the opacity is 100%, and the angle is 90 degrees. The distance is 30 pixels, the size is 40 pixels, and the contour is linear. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Emboss, the technique is Smooth, and the depth is 210%. The direction is up, the size is 30 pixels, and the soften is 5 pixels. Use Global Light is unchecked. The angle is 120 degrees, and the altitude is 50 degrees. The highlight mode is Linear Dodge, the color is white, and the opacity is 20%. The shadow mode is Hard Light, and its opacity is 20% as well. Click the color box and type in 5, 8, 2, C19. Then click OK on both windows. Lastly, we'll distort the overall shape and add air bubbles to our latte art. Go to Filter, Distort, and Zigzag. Make the amount 21, the ridges 6, and the style out from center. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. We'll make a composite snapshot of our visible image so we can add air bubbles to the art. Press Alt-Control-Shift-E on Windows or Option-Command-Shift-E on a Mac. Open the Patch tool. This tool essentially matches the texture of sampled pixels using selection-defined areas instead of a brush. At the top, we have a choice of 2 patch modes, Normal and Content Aware. Choose Normal. There's also 2 buttons, Source and Destination. When the Source button is selected, draw a selection within the art and drag it outside the art and release. Then deselect it. Notice it copied the outside texture and then blended it onto the art. When the Destination button is selected, draw a selection outside the art and drag it inside the art to fill it with a texture. If I draw a selection and drag it over an edge, that edge is softened because the patch tool blended them together. Continue to add air bubbles to areas of your latte art until you're happy with the result. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.